I'm here with director Joe Lynch, who directed Zombie Movie.
Hello.
And I guess we're going to be talking about the movie and the score and how it happened. So the basic premise, if you guys don't know, is that Cecil Kaufman owns this drive-in, yep. And it's the last night of the drive-in. He's going to be showing these great old splatter films.
Yeah, before the drive-in gets torn down.
Exactly. I was using this as an excuse to draw from so many of my favorite pieces of music and favorite composers that I haven't had an excuse to. I think for that, there were three decades that I needed to sound like, too. There was stuff that needed to sound like the 50s. Mm-hmm. You needed to sound like the 70s for Defecation.
Yep.
And we needed to sound like the 80s for what was sort of the bulk of the score. So, like, for example, for the 80s stuff, I mean, John Carpenter was, of course, an influence for that bare bones synthesizer. Mm-hmm. I almost use the word cheesy, but it's only cheesy when people knock it off,
yeah.
If that makes sense. To me though, the biggest influence I had musically was 1980s Jerry Goldsmith. Now, yes. Being a Jerry Goldsmith fan, most people that I talk to that, you know, that love his scores.
Said early 80s.
Well, what I was going to say is, you know, people that love Jerry Goldsmith generally love Alien and Star Trek, mm-hmm. and they don't like the Goldsmith scores that are, I hate to say this, some of my favorites, which are Gremlins, The Burbs, Rambo. So when I saw your big montages where people are getting in trouble, shall I say. Now, this is extreme. I mean, I had never seen anything like this. And I mean, it is disgusting, but it's also fun and really funny. And that's why I wanted to, like, rather than drawing for those scenes where it's really outrageous, rather than drawing from Carpenter, which is, let me put it this way, it's like John Carpenter is using synthesizers and Jerry Goldsmith is using synthesizers around the same time in the mm-hmm. 80s.
Yeah.
Carpenter is trying to make it very spooky mm-hmm. and serious. Goldsmith, because he's coming from this huge orchestral palette that he normally works with, for him, the synthesizers are fun.
So him on a day off.
Exactly. So for him, doing a movie like Gremlins, it's like, gee, this is great. I can have fun with this stuff. I'm not trying to take myself seriously. That's the kind of energy that I wanted to put into Zombie Movie.
Well, that's, you know, any fan of yours, just from listening to, if you listen to any of your other work, and then you listen to this.
Which I recommend doing as a fun AB
Well, that's
comparison.
The thing. It's like, you can really see that, like, that's almost exactly what Goldsmith did with his stuff, where he was like, you know what?
Yeah.
I'm going to have some fun.
Yeah.
And, yeah. I mean, that's when I remember getting the tracks back, I could picture you in your cave, you know, the lights low, you have candles on, and you put a light down underneath you so you have
that
some
does,
serious,
that
like,
really does
light.
Help. The creative juices.
I knew it! And you're just going like Phantom of the fucking Opera.
Yeah.
You know? And but having a blast doing it. You know?
So what did you think when I sent you those tracks for the first time? I mean, was that what you were expecting? Or?
Oh, no. Well, that's the thing. I didn't expect you to kick so much ass the first right out of the gate. You know, I remember, like, the first time I sent notes, I'm like, I don't know what to say. Like, maybe just make that hit a little bit, like, different, or just shift that, like, cue over there. But usually when we've sent stuff back and forth, it's, you know, a feeling of tone here or maybe like rise moment here or maybe leave that moment alone. Everything was so spot on, but that's that sense of fun that you were talking about, that's the sense of fun that I had when I was shooting, because like during the day I was doing Nights of Badassum. So at night it was like, all right, let's go nuts, let's have a blast with our friends and just have zombies have sex in a drive-in. Pretty awesome.
The other scores that I drew from, speaking of horror scores, were Bernard Herrmann scores from the 50s and 60s.
Anyone in particular?
Like Journey to the Center of the Earth, Day the Earth Stood Still. There's this grandeur.
See, I heard Earth Stood Still in the opening.
Totally. Well, that's mainly what I'm talking about, is the opening and the ending, which needed to have this B-movie aesthetic, but needed to be really big, because especially it was the beginning.
What the hell?
There is something in this movie that seems to be wildly upsetting people. Why don't you tell us what that is?
Well, that would be Defecation, which I feel is the raison d'etre of the entire project, which ultimately was really just designed to be one big red herring, because we were always, the whole idea behind Chillerama was that the final film, the final short, was going to be something that happened in the wraparounds. So we needed something that I could get in and get out really quick, but also be in the same vein.
And you needed something that would be as shocking and memorable in 2 minutes as a 20-minute movie.
So Fernando Fagabifi, the director of Deathication, basically tells the audience, this movie is going to make you defecate or defecate or whatever. And then a montage of probably the only taboo I feel has not quite been smashed through, which is feces. Everything that happens in zombie movie and defecation and all that is all things I went, why hasn't someone done that? For better or worse. Maybe there's a really good
there
reason.
There probably is a reason.
There's a really good reason why no done one's that done too. That shit. And defecation is the epitome of that. So, but we needed something that I could get in and get out, you know, so, very quickly. And
so you cut together this thing and
which was shot, Defecation is shot all in what, 6 hours we shot it?
I think so.
Yeah. We shot between Fernando Fagabifi's speech and Bear's illustrious cameo, which
yes!
I'm very proud of.
My cameo.
Big cameo.
Another, I'm an artist.
Another fartist.
Yes.
We shot that all in like five or six hours yeah. altogether, and then I had it all cut and sent it
honestly,
over to you.
I spent more time writing the piece of music, especially if you consider the 19-minute version that is on the album, complete with like huge guitar solos and spoken word beat poetry recorded in a live club. I spent more time on the piece of music, probably by a factor of 10, than you spent writing it, shooting it, cutting it.
You're the man.
I know.
So I wanted to make something that kind of looked akin to a John Waters movie mixed with a little William Castle. So the film looks and feels like it was shot on 16mm stock back in the day. So the music, again, had to kind of evoke that feeling too. So we're like, we can just pull out all the stops and like channel Isaac Hayes out every sleazy 70s hook that you could.
A lot of wah pedal in there.
Oh my God, there's a lot of waka waka.
I remember this one really funny moment where I was in the studio with Rhea doing vocals. And we were thinking, you know, there's that great part in Shaft when they yell, Shaft! But we can't yell Shaft, what can we yell? What can we put here? And it took us about 10 or 20 seconds. We're like, I don't know, you have any ideas? And then.
I can safely attest that it is one of the coolest things we've ever done.
And here's the weird thing. The zombie movie itself was how long? 48 minutes?
About 44 minutes altogether.
44 minutes. The album is 60 minutes.
How does that work? I don't
and
get it.
20 minutes of it is Defecation, the extended version. Oh, actually, we called it Defecation Movement Number 2. When you listen to the album, and it's there in your movie too, is that there really is a sweet character story in here. There really is this sort of Joe Dante-esque 80s movie in there. And because it's broken up by these films that are looking like they're from all these different eras, you lose a little of that. And it is fun to be able to, you know, listen to the album and feel all that, you know, because it's all there.
Well, Bear, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you for being part of Chillerama. I don't know what we...
Thank you for letting me work on it for free. I mean, for lots of money. Thank you for paying my fee, which is very expensive.
That's better.
Yeah.
That's much better.
Yeah.
And now, tell us a little bit about the soundtrack. When are we gonna be able to get our meat paws on the soundtrack?
The soundtrack is out today. The soundtrack is coming out. The CD is available through Buy Soundtracks Records.
Cool.
The first 100...
My favorite people in the whole world.
Yes. The first 100 CDs are going to be signed by you, me, and Brendan McCreary from Young, Beautiful, and a Hurry. But anyway, go to buysoundtracks.com or look for details here on my blog.
Chillerama.
Chillerama
is coming out November 29th. It's going to be out from Image Entertainment. It's going to be on Blu-ray and DVD, and it's already out on VOD now. So if you... just you listen to the soundtrack and you're like, oh my God, I need to see this movie now. Go to your cable provider and you can find it on VOD as well. And I'm sure it'll be on iTunes at some point. But yeah, just know this was a complete labor of love for everybody involved. And we couldn't have done it without each other.
Yes.
And we couldn't do it without you, the fans. And thank you for that.
Yeah.
And it's been awesome. Hope you like it. It's disgusting.
Yeah, be warned, it's very disgusting.
Oh, let's just also mention, we got paid a lot of money, too.
This is definitely
money just pouring out of my pockets. You see my, you know, my new car out front. He's got a jet.
This was
thank you, Chillerama. Thank you.